like Caleb. Caleb spoke faith over his challenge. Caleb had a different spirit compared to his generation. Numbers 13 and verse 30, we see Caleb speaking to Moses. Then Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and take possession, for we are well able to overcome it." While his generation embraced the evil report of the ten spies, here was Caleb confessing his faith. Here was Caleb confessing something different from the failure that his contemporaries were confessing. And what was the outcome of such a confession? What was the outcome of such an overcoming faith? We find that Caleb inherited a very different future compared to the others. The others, in fact, never got a chance to move into the promised land. But Caleb, along with Joshua, were the only two from their generation who had the opportunity to enter the promised land. What made this possible for Caleb? It was his overcoming spirit and his confession of faith. Now, let us, in our adversities, speak faith. Speak faith over our challenges, just like Caleb. Now, Caleb did not stop with speaking his faith once. What we could understand about him is that he was a man of faith who constantly and consistently held on to his confession of faith. Let's read now from Joshua chapter 14, verses 12 and 13. "Now, therefore, give me this mountain of which the Lord spoke in that day. For you heard in that day how the Anakim were there and that the cities were great and fortified. It may be that the Lord will be with me and I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said." And Joshua blessed him and gave Hebron to Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, as an inheritance. Caleb spoke his faith as a young man. And Joshua chapter 14 is probably around the time when Caleb was 85 years old. So he had to wait a good 45 years before the inheritance which was promised to him was given. Now look at the faith of this elderly person. He continues to believe God for the inheritance. For 45 years, he has not given up on the promise. He speaks to Joshua and he says, "Give me my mountain. Give me what was promised to me." So Caleb had faith, but Caleb also had patience. In Hebrews 11, we read that with faith and patience, we inherit the promises of God. This is something we can learn from Caleb. Let's have faith. Let's confess our faith and let's not give up on our faith till we possess the land, till we get our inheritance, till we see God's promises fulfilled. Let's pray together. Father God, we praise you that, Lord, you are a God who loves us, a God who is merciful towards us, a God who has made all provision abound to us through Jesus Christ. And Lord, give us a spirit like Caleb, O God, that we could overcome in our situations. And Father, that we could hold on to that confession of faith. And Lord, truly, we believe that, God, you will enable us, O God, to possess our promises. Lord, we stand on those promises, Father, till we see the fulfillment of those promises. Father, we ask, would you strengthen us by your word? Would you strengthen us by your Holy Spirit? That, Lord, we could stand till the end. And God, like Caleb, we could claim our mountain, that we could claim our inheritance, and that we could glorify your name. We give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.